Hello and welcome back to your own channel Indian Defense Analysis, where we bring to you all the latest development happening in the defense sector.
Recently, I bumped into an article where they have mentioned same old song about depleting fleet of Indian Air Force, powerful Chinese Air Force, Sukhoi low service ability, immature Tejas fighter jet, old mix, problem with MMRCA procurement, issues with Jaguar, more reliability of Indian Air Force on French technology, etc. I will say, either they are fools or ignorant. I will share the link of the article in description section. I am not fully disagreeing with what is written in the article, but they should be more cautious while writing against or criticizing Indian Air Force. Because there are some budget constraints of India, unlike China, we are a democratic country. Government has to answer for large defense deals, as we have seen in the Rafale case. Absolutely, we have long pending defense deals and old fighter jets. But one must not forget that our MiG-21 shot down the advanced F-16 in air skirmish between Indian Air Force and Pakistan. However, before countering the article, let's see what they have written in the article. To summarize the article was mainly focused on depleting strength of Indian Air Force, and it will take 10 to 15 years to achieve the strength of 35 squadrons, which is still insufficient considering the two-front war situation with China and Pakistan. They have compared Chinese Air Force fleet with Indian Air Force fleet and mentioned that Indian Air Force fleet is half the size of PLAF. Again criticizing the old MiG-21 and Jaguar fleets. Low service ability of Sukhoi 30 MKI fleets. As per the article, Sukhoi 30 MKI have below 50% service ability. Then it mentioned about Tejas MK1, of which there are two squadrons is affected with issues including an underpowered engine and inadequate range, meaning Indian Air Force is cautious of deploying it anywhere near hostile borders. HAL Tejas MK1A is still on drawing board, and if prototype is successful, it will enter the service by 2024 onwards. AMCA is still on drawing board over procurement quantity of Tejas MK2 fighter jets and MMRCA 2.0 delayed procurement. After signing of the contract, it will take 12 years to induct 114 fighter jets into Indian Air Force. In the last, if China and Pakistan together attack India in current situation, Indian Air Force will have its hand full and Chinese or Pakistani will outperform Indian Air Force. As we all know that Indian Air Force alone cannot win the battle for India. If battle happens, Indian Navy, Indian Air Force and Army will have to give their best to defend India. To counter Pakistan, we are going to need just 100 aircraft
and remaining 500 can be saved for China.
China also uses Sukhoi 30 MKI and they have 400 MiG-21 fighters. At the same time, China has total 1,300 fighter jets, out of which they cannot deploy all the fighter jets along the Indian border. It will be completely impractical to do so. Now coming to the service ability, it is not something new with Indian Air Force. Even China and Pakistan both have to face such issue with their fighter jets. Now talking about Tejas fighter jets, yes, there are some issues with Tejas MK1 and the same issue is being sorted out in MK1A. Tejas have zero accidents since induction and we have lot of pictures of Tejas near Ladakh border, which shows that Indian Air Force have faith in Tejas MK1. I will not talk about Tejas MK1A and AMCA program because it is being developed and I hope it will be in production as per the plan. Obviously, there are some engineering challenges like jet engine and we have to overcome those challenges. Now talking about MMRCA 2.0, RFI issued in 2018 and it's been 3 years since RFI. Now as per some recent reports, Indian Air Force is evaluating the RFI and RFP will be issued in next year. Let's evaluate Chinese Air Force and Indian Air Force based on current squadron strength. At present, China has 1,300 aircraft, out of which 400 aircraft are MiG-21 and about 800 are J-10 and J-11 aircraft, which are aircraft of 3rd and 4th generation. China currently uses 4.5th generation aircraft in 150 numbers, while India has about 350 4.5th generation aircraft, which includes 50 MiG-21 Bison, which is 4th generation aircraft, 260 Sukhoi 30 MKI and 120 is Jaguar. चाइना कैन हार्डली डिप्लॉय 100 फोर्थ जनरेशन और 4.5th जनरेशन एयरक्राफ्ट अगेंस्ट इंडिया। इन रिस्पॉन्स इंडिया कैन यूज इट्स 250 4.5th जनरेशन एयरक्राफ्ट अगेंस्ट चाइना एंड 100 एयरक्राफ्ट कैन बी सेव्ड फॉर पाकिस्तान। आई विल टेल यू लेटर व्हाई चाइना कैन डिप्लॉय ओनली 100 फाइटर जेट्स अगेंस्ट इंडिया। चाइना हैज द बिगेस्ट चैलेंज इन तिब्बत। द स्मॉलेस्ट पीक ऑफ द तिब्बत इज ऑफ 13,000 फीट and in such mountainous area, no fighter jet can do maneuver with full weapon payload. That is why if China has to attack on Indian base, then they can never attack us with full payload as they have to return to their base, so additional fuel tank will also require for the same. In the end, China will have one option left. China should put all its air force against India, and to do so, China will have to face two big problems. First, China at present there are only 4 airfield in Tibet, because of which China will not be able to use its entire air fleet even if it want to. Second, by doing this China will have to face a huge security threat on Russia, Taiwan and east border, which China would never think to do so. China has 15 air refueler aircraft, which is not sufficient for refueling the aircraft of entire PLAF. Not only this, Indian airfield arc is built from Srinagar to Chabua. We can achieve the air dominance on the whole battlefield by using Himalayas as a shield. And very easily our Tejas, Jaguar will ruin China's land air force armor, logistic, troop concentration camps. In a such situation, China will have to face thousands of casualties. At last, I have not counted on Rafale, which will be the game changer in the fight. One Rafale is equivalent to 2.5 Sukhoi 30 MKI. 36 Rafale is equal to 90 Sukhoi 30 MKI. China has no match for Rafale, even its mighty J-20. And their air force know it very well. China definitely has edge over numbers, but when it comes to face Indian air force, they lack battle experience and war expertise. To summarize the whole Chinese military capability, they are just large group of inexperienced cowards equipped with stolen technology from the West, which is not even battle proven. Jai Hind. This was today's update. Please let us know what is your view about these in comment section. Feel free to post your comments and suggestions on any topic related to defense sector on which you want to hear from us. With this, I would like to say goodbye and Jai Hind friends. Please like and subscribe our channel if you had not done already. We will soon back with more interesting and amazing development happening in the defense sector.